Welcome back, everybody! Welcome to another episode in the Legendlands. My name is Rosie Gemini, and welcome to my creative world. So, what are we going to do today? Well, we are going to fix something. Because in the previous episode, I was supposed to add this build in. However, I don't like it. So, this is the laundry room, and I don't like it. So, I'm going to be redoing it. Yes, I know it's all fine, whatever, and I don't need to redo it, sure, but I don't care. It doesn't suit the way that I want things to be done, and I just want to redo it. So that's what we're going to do. Now, this is my opportunity to give you guys that tour of what it looked like before, because again, this should have been included in the previous episode, but I am scratching that and deciding to go with something else. Well, let me give you a little bit of the backstory on this room, and then we will go into the new stuff that we are planning to do. So let's get to it. We have the laundry room, so this will be the laundry room. So these are the blocks that I'll probably be using within the zones. They're not the only blocks I will be using. A massive laundry room, but this is for a castle. There are a lot of people who live here, and I think that it's gonna turn out fabulous. Let's find out. You guys may be wondering, Rosie, why would you have such a large room for a laundry room? Well, the reason is we're going to be putting in some large wash basins that are able to handle the loads of laundry. Now, modern day washing is a modern day thing. So having machines and everything, we might still put some in, obviously. But I wanted to give both a nod to the previous and the new. So we're gonna have a lot of space for washing and drying and all the processes that would be required for that. And we will also have some machines in here. So that would take care of your laundry. I got a bit of work to do. Let's go.
Check it out, guys. We have the walls in. We even, in fact, have the basins in. So one of these is going to be for your whites, and the other would be for your coloreds, so that they wouldn't bleed, or you would be able to make them look all the same. Whatever you needed it for. It's for your colors. This is for your washing of the whites and stuff. Yeah, I know laundry. But we did get all the walls in. You will notice that all of the walls are not exactly the same. And that is okay by me, because the wall was supposed to be pure sandstone, and I was like, no. So I was like, not gonna happen. Also, over here would have been either more basins or something else that would have been, you know, taken out over time. Smaller basins, probably. But I am going to plan to make this into the area with the washing machines and everything else. They have tried to modernize and succeeded in some respects. But we also need to include a couple more things. We need to put a ceiling on here. We need to put the windows in. And maybe even a doorway or two. We'll see. You know, the typical laundry list. After about 8 tries, I have finally come up with a ceiling that I like. I think that it works well enough. No, I like it. I like it a lot, and this corner in particular was driving me crazy, because it's not directly across. There's, like, so many reasons why this just does not work, and yes, I could have had a flat roof or whatever, or a ceiling, but I decided, hey, let's, you know, make it curved and everything, and then the problem starts, and you guys know how it goes. I get something in my head, and I'm like, no, I want it this way, and then end up having to change 50 other elements. As you guys can see, this place needs lighting, this place needs doors, I need to get back to my laundry list. I will be right back. It is all finished. We do have everything in. We've got all the wash basins. We have some drying racks. So as you can see, some sheets are drying right now with the grates down below to catch all the water. We have some clotheslines that can, after it stops dripping, then you hang it like you do over here, because this would be your, like, shirts or your pillowcases or something just a little bit smaller than sheets. And then we have tables where you can fold things. We've got the washing machine and the dryer, because we have advanced past the no technology zone. And then we have some folded, pre-folded clothes and everything. So there you go. That is the laundry room. I am okay with, I really like how it turned out. And I think that, you know, it has character. It is very interesting. And yeah, moving on. Let's move on.
All right. So one of the problems with this room was that, as you guys can see, you needed three different light sources in order to cover everything. And that's a lot of lighting. So we're gonna downsize that a little bit. And obviously, I just hated the ceiling. I really did. The walls, I'm still gonna probably tear down just a little bit and make them into something I'm actually proud of. But yeah, the lighting was one of the biggest problems here, and we will be fixing all of that. So this is one of those problems that we were having where things are just slightly off and nothing is quite exactly where it should be. And so as you can see, between the pillars here, the window is not being framed. Between the pillars here, it's not even. Between any of the pillars, the walls are just not sitting right. We were having two wide pillars, and now I'm making them into three wide pillars, and we just need to make sure that everything is going to look immaculate and perfect. And it's one thing for your build to be off a little bit, but this room has been bugging me since I built it. So I'm glad that I'm coming back and we're fixing it into a much better state than what it used to be. So let's get these walls done and we will have fixed some of the issues. This is how off we were on the windows. That's insane. Like, this window needs to be so far over. Everything needs to be over. You never think about it until you're like, I don't think this is going right. And now we're fixing it. We have to be very, very careful right now because the walls are so busy, and they were always busy. Look at these. These are very busy walls. But because these walls are so busy, we need something very simplistic for the ceiling. These walls are so very, the arches and everything, they, with the walls and everything, and I do like the walls and the arches and pieces, but this is a laundry room. So we need to be very, very careful that we're not over detailing it for no reason, and that it is going to have a purpose of some kind, and we're gonna make this all work. Alright, so we got the walls all in and looking nice. I really like how they have turned out. I like how they've popped in the color. We've kept some places more simplistic, while others are more ornate, and that is okay. As you can see from some of the previous amenities, a lot has changed. So many of the walls have been taken out, so many buttons have been taken out, things like that. So it really shows me exactly how much the walls have changed. As you can see, we've still got some hooks over here, but we don't have any hooks over here, except for this one tiny little hook right there. So it really shows you exactly how much I've already changed this room, and it's all for the better. It looks so much better. As you guys can pretty much tell, we need to fix the floor. We need to fix a bit of everything, as well as put in a ceiling. So that's where we're headed next. Alright, so we have the ceiling done, and I like it. It does need lighting, clearly in two different spots, but we will get that lighting in, and then we will have this build finished off. See you guys in one moment when I have completed all the little tasks that need to go into this build. Alright, check it out! Oh my gosh, it looks so much better. Like, beyond better. So much. Oh my goodness. I can't even begin to tell you guys, like, how much this build was just in the back of my head as upsetting me, but I didn't know what to do or to fix it, or, you know, I wasn't putting in effort or time or anything. But anyway, let me show you guys around. We have some tables and we have ladders that go up to the high points so that you can unhook and rehook and move things around as much as you want, as you guys can see. We have a sheet or something here that is drip drying basically, and it'll be flat ironed or whatever later. As well as we have some sticks that help to stir the water. So you have a red basin, a blue basin, a black basin, a yellow basin, and a white one. So that's gonna get all of your coloring needs based off of what kind of wash you need to put onto the cloth item. So we could turn these white sheets into yellow, we could turn them into black, red, blue, you know, whatever the person wants. Thus we have the pink sheets over here because apparently one of the kids that live within this castle is a tiny little tyke that loves her pink. But we have tables over here, we've got some cleaning detergents and things like that, we've got some brooms to sweep up after yourself, or mops or whatever, I don't know. But we have tables. It is hidden lighting, and so yay. But we have grates for drip drying, and we have over here your normal washer and dryers, okay? So this is for coloring, this is for washing your clothes. So we need a bunch of them because this is a castle. And many people live within a castle. A lot of servants, a lot of security details, and we want to make sure everybody has as much possibility to have a washer and a dryer. You know, you just put in your laundry and press the button and good to go. And then we come over here to this side and we have bolts of fabric, and we have our sewing machines over here with our two seamstresses who are working on a nice cute pink little hat, some blue jeans, and a new shirt or blouse for the queen. And I love how the ceiling came out. It's so much better. We can just pretend that other ceiling never happened. It had a lot of good ideas, and then it just was a failed execution on so many levels. And part of the reason for that is because of the shape of this room in the first place. I was trying to overcomplicate it, and don't overcomplicate your builds, guys. It won't turn out well, I promise you that. But that's gonna do it for this episode. So leave a like if you like the video, subscribe if you want to see more, and comment in the comment section down below if you guys have any ideas that would improve the build, or you just want to say hello. This has been Rosie Gemini, and as always, guys, stay rosy in that darkness.